How I make my homemade cinnamon rolls in a little bit longer, more detailed tutorial. I like to use my KitchenAid stand mixer, so I grab the bowl and add in half a cup of sugar, 2.5 tablespoons of active dry yeast, and a half a cup of warm water. Now you can check the water on your wrist to test the temperature, kind of like you do for a baby's bottle. You want it warm enough, but not so hot that it burns you. Now in a heavy bottom saucepan, add 2 cups of milk and put it over medium heat. You want to scald your milk, which means you're going to bring it to where it almost boils, but then right before it's gonna boil, turn it off. Add a stick of butter to the milk, let it melt, and then cool off that mixture. You want it to be almost room temperature. It can be a little warm, but definitely not hot. Now, once it's cooled, add it to your yeast mixture, and then add in 1.5 teaspoons of salt, 2 large eggs, and then 5 to 7 cups of flour. Usually I'll add in like my first 3 cups of flour and let that mix and then slowly add in up to another 4 cups. You can always add more flour, but you cannot take flour away. So add a cup at a time and let it work into the dough until it's not sticking to the sides of the bowl. Like you can see here, as my beater goes around, the dough is not sticking. Now you want to knead the dough for about 5 to 7 minutes until it passes what is called the window pane test, like I'm doing here. You get a little ball and you pull it out into a rectangle and it should get really thin without tearing. If it will do that, you know it is kneaded enough. Now place it in a warm spot until it is doubled in size. I usually will turn my oven on for a few minutes and then just turn it back off and put it in the oven to double. If I'm using my oven for something different, I will put it in my car. I know it sounds kind of crazy, but especially if it's a nice hot day or a warm day, it's the perfect spot for it to rise. Okay, so once it's double in size, it usually takes about an hour, roll it out to an 18 by 24 inch rectangle and brush it with a stick of melted butter and then add a cup of brown sugar and 2 tablespoons of ground cinnamon. Now roll this up nice and tight. You don't want to tear at the dough, but you want to roll it nice and tight and then cut it out into 1 inch thick slices. Place those slices into a buttered pan, either like a 9 by 13, whatever size you want to use. And now you're going to want to let them rise again. This time it's going to take about 30 to 45 minutes. Put them back in the warm spot, cover them with a towel, and let them rise until they're doubled again. Now, once they're doubled again, and if you're using your oven, you'll want to preheat your oven before they're done rising. So make sure you pull them out before you turn the oven on. So preheat your oven to 350 degrees and then bake them for about 18 to 22 minutes until they are golden brown. Now, once they are done, or while they're in there, you can make your frosting. For your frosting, I use 4 ounces of cream cheese. Make sure it's softened. Half a stick of softened butter, 1 teaspoon of vanilla, 1 pinch of salt, 1 pound of powdered sugar. Mix all that in together and then slowly add just a little bit of milk until it reaches the consistency that you're looking for. You don't want it to be too thick, but you also don't want it to be too watery. So add just enough milk to get that right consistency. If you accidentally add too much milk, you can always add a little bit more powdered sugar to thicken it back up. Now pull your cinnamon rolls out of the oven and then ice them as much as you want with your icing. If you don't like the icing, you can of course leave that off. If you have someone in the family that likes extra icing, you can give them the extra. And yeah, that's it. That's how I make my cinnamon rolls. Hope you guys enjoy this recipe and let me know if you try to make them. I'd love to hear how it goes for you.